Precious little generosity off the pitch for Samoa. Precious little on it. England duly completed their autumn series with the 3 wins out of 3 demanded by Eddie Jones. A side that is winning is all he wants, and if they can win by good-looking margins, so much the better. 3 wins. Yes. But 3 scorelines. 2. That might be accounted a little flattering. Still, there is another team who have proved masters of the flattering scoreline, and they've been #1 in the world for what seems like an eternity. The teams here took a few moments together at the end. Blue and white arms interlinked. Knees bent in a ring of solidarity. Much love then for Samoa everywhere. But love will get them only so far. Their union recently announced themselves as bankrupt, and they finished similarly bereft, staring at a 3-0 deficit that mirrors their situation just as aptly as England's series result does. Bears. Elliot Daly helps 7-try England race away with it against Samoa. Read more. Jones was satisfied. He acknowledged how Samoa's back row had routed England's at the breakdown, particularly in the second half. But otherwise, Coach Cam revealed him to be quite calm throughout. The intensity of this contest, if no less punishing for those on the receiving end of the big bones of the Samoans, was clearly a notch down as an experience from the rain-lashed test of the previous week against Tier 1 opposition, or even that of the week before that, after which Jones had felt obliged to apologize for his language. This time, there was serenity all round. Mind you, the Samoa coaches might have been effing and blinding for all anyone knew. For some reason, Titimia Tafua, their head coach, did not prove quite the draw for the camera that Michael Checa or Jones had. There was never any doubt about the result, which always helps when it comes to blood pressure management. Tim Nanai Williams, an outside back pressed into fly half duties on this trip, had an uncomfortable afternoon, his kicking particularly loose, and when he dropped George Ford's high ball, a skill he should be rather more adept at. England had the second of their tries within 10 minutes. Nanai Williams and his mates are happier with ball in hand. At that point, the signs were ominous, but Samoa replied within 3 minutes, seizing upon the spill by the otherwise excellent Charlie Yules at the restart. The Islanders' power round the fringes kept them in the game, just as it had against Scotland 2 weeks ago. In many ways, though, England's first half was the more accomplished. Alex Lazowski and Henry Slade shining in midfield, as they had in the summer tour to Argentina. Outside Ford, who proved again, as on the same tour, that he can thrive without Owen Farrell easing the pressure. There was a different feel to this England team, in other words. It was not full strength. Not that it was not packed with thrusting candidates eager to make Jonas' life as uncomfortable as he likes to make theirs. Many of the same had done exactly that in Argentina. This very midfield proving every bit as flexible as they had in the memorable first test in San Juan. Those stood down here would no doubt contend that this was not a fair comparison. This was never going to be anything other than a loose match, where the kind of talents the more hard-bitten might consider a luxury at test level were given ample scope for expression. Nevertheless, one man who was not there in the summer was Jamie George, offered a rare chance to stake a claim over England's captain, Dylan Hartley. Other players have had to spend as much time, or more, as George on the international bench, but few, while they have so obviously won the rugby playing argument over their rival. George was not in Argentina because he was playing for the Lions, where he won the rugby argument all but unchallenged over the best the rest of these Isles have to offer in the hooker department. The intangible of Hartley's leadership is crucial to Jonas' vision for England's World Cup. So George, despite playing key roles here, often as a would-be center, in 2 of England's first half tries will have to bide his time still longer. Hartley came on in the final quarter and will happily point to England's 3 tries in the last 10 minutes. He, too, found himself with ball in hand for England's last. It would be excessively mischievous to mention he sent his pass to the deck, where George had earlier sent his into the arms of the try-scorer. But England recovered the ball for Slade to send Semesa Roko Duguni over at the death for England's 7th. The same combination for the final pass that had caused such controversy in the win over Argentina. So England finished their autumn as they had started it with tries by Pacific Islanders. Garnishes to embellish a machine that continues to move satisfactorily at this midpoint between World Cups. They remain favorites for what would be a third consecutive Six Nations title next year.